This was a 20-day back-to-back cruise out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida to the Southern Caribbean, return to Fort Lauderdale, and then doing the Eastern Caribbean. The first planned stop was at the Princess Keys. However, bad weather deterred us from getting in there, so the next stop was St. Thomas, Virgin Islands, and we did not really take pictures there because we've been there many times before. Our next stop was Martinique, which is a French island, and it has 385,000 people, and its currency is a euro. This young lady was our pedicab driver, and she is a student studying jazz music at the local university. Very nice kid. The next several pictures are merely scenes from around the city when we did our cab ride. Our next stop was Grenada, which is located in the southern Spanish Andalusian region, and it has a population of 235,000. There always seems to be at least one of these ships in every port that we visit, but it's always kind of fun to take a picture of it for posterity. We didn't take many pictures in Grenada because we've been there before. Bonaire is owned by the Netherlands and it has a population of 16,500 and it uses a US dollar for currency. We have visited Bonaire on several other occasions, so again we didn't take a lot of pictures. However, it's a beautiful island and it's noted for its diving. Curaçao is owned by the Netherlands and it has a population of 160,000. Its language is Dutch and the currency used there is the guilder. We have been to St. Thomas numerous times, so most of the photographs that we were taking were recording the hurricane damage that was done in 2017. Thank you. St. Kitts is a commonwealth with a population of about 55,000, and they use the Eastern Caribbean dollar as their currency. St. Lucia is an independent nation. The language spoken there is English. Their population is about 170,000 people, and their currency is the Eastern Caribbean dollar. This is the lighthouse keeper and also the harbor master, and he holds up ship traffic when there's an airplane about to land. This was a beautiful garden that we visited on the island. It was quite nice. Antigua is an independent country with a population of about 80,000. Its economy is largely based around tourism and has Lord Nelson's Dockyard, which was a British naval base many years ago. Thank you. portable slave homes were built so that if a master became angry with one of his slaves, the slave could pick up the house and move it very quickly by disassembling it and moving it off of the stones.